Hello students, welcome to this video lecture. In this video lecture, we will be discussing the question number 142 of NEET 2017 question paper. The question is, with reference to factors affecting the rate of photosynthesis, which of the following statements is not correct? You have to find out the incorrect statements. The four options given are, let's discuss the options one by one. The first option is, light saturation for CO2 fixation occurs at 10% of full sunlight. Yes, this is the correct option. Now, let us discuss what do you mean by light saturation. Saturation is something like full. Okay. Remember like this. Okay. Saturation means something like full. Now, whenever, see, sunlight, chlorophyll, carbon dioxide, water, all these are raw materials for the process of photosynthesis, right? Agree? I also agree. When you increase the raw materials, then obviously the rate of reaction should increase. Yes or no? The rate of reaction should increase. Yes, it will increase, but up to a certain limit. Okay, after this limit, it will become stable like this, right? It will become stable, it will become constant, it will not increase. And if you further increase the intensity of sunlight or raw materials, then it can decrease as well. The rate of reaction can decrease as well, right? So you have to maintain the optimum level. What do you mean by the optimum level? Where the rate of reaction is highest, right? It should not exceed the optimum level too much. It should not come down of the optimum level too much, right? So you have to maintain a particular optimum level. When you talk about light saturation, the CO2 fixation rate is highest, or it cannot increase after 10% of full sunlight. Okay. So what do you mean by this? If you provide 15% of full sunlight, then you will see a decrease in rate of photosynthesis. Okay, this is the meaning of saturation, that the saturation level is attained at 10% of full sunlight. Even if you increase the sunlight beyond 10%, there will not be any increase in the rate of photosynthesis. Now, when you see the second option, increasing atmospheric CO2 concentration up to 0.05% can enhance CO2 fixation rate. Yes, this is correct. See, this doesn't mean that we increase the carbon dioxide levels in the atmosphere drastically, okay? Because if the carbon dioxide is increasing in the atmosphere, the photosynthesis rate will be increased, right? No, that is not the case. You can see the percentage that is given, that is really low, yes or no? That is 0.05%, right? But we are increasing it beyond 5%, right? So this is not good, right? So second option is the correct option. When you see the third option, let's discuss about the C3 and C4 plants first. C3 plants, the photosynthesis only occurs in one place, and it is facilitated, it is aided by an enzyme, RUBP. In C4 plants, the photosynthesis occurs in two places, bundle sheet cells and the mesophyll cells, and two enzymes are there, PEP, phosphoenol pyruvate, and RUBP, RUBISCO, right? Now, 90% of the angiosperms are of C3 plants and the rest 10% are of C4 plants. Now here, as you can see, that the C4 plants have much lower temperature optimum, right? What I just said about optimum? Optimum means the temperature or the condition. It should not be always temperature, okay? Optimum is any condition in which the rate of that particular reaction is maximum, right? For C4 plants, at lower temperature, this PP will get inactivated. Okay, the PEP will get inactivated. So can you think that if PEP gets inactivated, then the rate of photosynthesis can be optimum? No, right? So it does not have much lower temperature optimum. Okay, it has a higher temperature optimum. Okay, because it need PEP, it require PEP. Okay, it need higher temperature optimum. And C4 plants responds to generally lower temperatures with enhanced photosynthesis, right? So this is not the correct option, right? So okay, so these are the correct options. That is why this cannot be the answer, right? Because we are discussing which one is not correct, right? So this is not correct, so this will be the answer, right? Let's discuss the fourth option as well. Tomato is a greenhouse crop. What do you mean by a greenhouse crop? Greenhouse crop is a crop that will grow, that will show increased growth and increased yield when the CO2 is increased, right? Greenhouse gas, CO2 is a most important greenhouse gas, right? That is the reason why it is known as greenhouse crop, because increase in CO2 will increase the growth and yield of that particular crop. So tomato is a greenhouse crop. It can be grown in CO2 enriched atmosphere for higher yield. Yes, this is correct. And tomato is an example of C3 plant. So correct option is option number 3. That is the wrong statement. Thank you.